బి ఆగ్లవి వర్కింగ్ యాజ్ అన్ అసిస్టెంట్ ప్రొఫెసర్ ఇన్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ మెకానికల్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ వాల్చిన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆఫ్ టెక్నాలజీ సోలాపూర్. సో టుడే ఇన్ ద థర్డ్ సెషన్ విల్ సీ సైక్రోమెట్రిక్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ అండ్ న్యూమరికల్స్ లెర్నింగ్ అవుట్కమ్స్. అట్ ద ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ సెషన్ స్టూడెంట్స్ విల్ బీ ఏబుల్ టు డిరైవ్ స్పెసిఫిక్ ఎంథాల్పీ అండ్ ఇవాల్యుయేట్ సైక్రోమెట్రిక్ ప్రాపర్టీస్. Now, in this session, we will see the specific humidity of moist air. Specific humidity of moist air is equal to humidity of dry air plus humidity of water vapor. If I consider the humidity per mass of air, then on both sides I will divide it by MA. Which is equal to EMA into specific enthalpy of air by MA plus MV into HV by MA. So, specific enthalpy of moist air is equal to specific enthalpy of dry air plus this ratio is specific humidity into HV. Now, this is the equation number first. As we know, specific humidity of dry air, as the air is in the gaseous phase, we can consider CpA means specific humidity, specific heat of air into dry bulb temperature. Now, this dry bulb temperature is nothing but small t, which is the same of air and water vapor. This is the equation number second. Now, to find the enthalpy of vapor, we have to refer the Mollier chart. So, on the Mollier chart, if we refer the Mollier chart, it is found that up to 50 degrees Celsius, the isenthalpic lines and isothermal lines are coinciding. So, if I draw here the isothermal line, then corresponding to isothermal, the isenthalpic lines are also coinciding on the same. So, what I can do? I can consider the reference temperature for the water vapor as 0 degree Celsius and the enthalpy of water vapor, instead of taking it as a dry air, that is suppose capital A, superheated B or state C. I can derive the general relation for the water vapor. So, HV is equal to HFG, this is the latent heat at 0 degree Celsius, plus CpV, specific humidity of superheated vapor, into dry bulb temperature minus 0. So, it becomes HFG at 0 degree Celsius plus CpV into dBT, dry bulb temperature. If we refer steam table, then at 0 degree Celsius, we will get the value of latent heat of vaporization as 2501 plus the CpV is 1.88 into T. This is the equation number 3. Then I should substitute the values of HA and HV in equation number first. So, enthalpy of moist air will be equal to CpAT plus omega into bracket 2501 plus 1.88 T. As CpA is 1.005 T plus specific humidity into bracket 2501 plus 1.88 T. So, this is the derivation of moist specific enthalpy of moist air. Next. Is numericals on moisture. There are two types of the numericals. In first category, they will be giving dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature. By using the psychrometer, we can obtain dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature. And if we refer the TS plot, then corresponding to dry bulb temperature from steam table, we will get PS. And from wet bulb temperature, by referring this TS plot, we will be getting PV dash. Here, we require to refer the carrier's equation. This is the first type of the numerical. In second type, we will be knowing along with the dry bulb temperature either relative humidity or specific humidity or degree of saturation. So, by equations we can find out the other psychrometric properties. Now, if I cool the air at PV pressure, then from steam table I may get the dew point temperature. So, this is the third method from which I can obtain the dew point temperature of that air, moist air. Next is the psychrometric processes. This is the psychrometric chart. I will consider 25 degree Celsius as dry bulb temperature and 50% RH. The intersection of these two properties will be the reference point. So, if I will heat the moist air without changing the specific volume, specific humidity, this process is known as sensible heating process. 1 to 2 is sensible heating process. If I cool it, means without changing omega, if I decrease its dry bulb temperature, the process 1 to 3 will be called sensible cooling process. If I start adding the water vapor, because omega is equal to mv by ma, if I will start adding the mass of water vapor in that moist air, then there will be increase in the omega. 1 to 4 will be known as humidification process. The reverse, if I remove the water vapor from that moist air, then 1 to 5 will be known as dehumidification process. Now, I can get the mixed processes also, that is process 1 to 6 will be heating with humidification and reverse cooling with dehumidification, 1 to 7. Then 1 to 8 will be cooling with humidification and 1 to 9 will be heating with dehumidification. So, these are the different psychrometric processes. Thank you.